Yay.
You mean you start from $0 then you earn money?
Yay, let's start now. Then we discuss that later. Now, first I have to understand the axis. You realize that, honeys, the axis is not mentioned on here. What I mean is, the axis is not, Marcus, what happened? The axis is not labeled. Now, how do I use a scenario to label? First, the word here is a against. Against means what? I have y against x. Do you know? Do you know it's always y against x?
Yeah.
So it's always y axis. It's always y axis against x axis. So what is my y axis?
Y axis the.
Just see bank
account. Very good interest. What is the x axis? Wrong.
The time.
So which means scenario one want to ask you, if this is interest, and this is time. Okay. If this is interest, this is time. How would the graph look like? So first, I have to look at the rule. The rule here is simple interest. So simple interest means the formula must come out. What's the formula?
BRT.
How do I, from here, get to know the graph? First, we identify the axis. Let's try. This is I, right? T means what?
Time.
The time. Which means I'm left with what? I can rewrite this as I equals to PR over 100 times time.
Ooh.
Do you know what I'm trying to do? I'm trying to separate out the T. Separate. Is it the same? Is this two the same?
Yes.
Yes. But why do I want to write here? Why do I want to write like that? Because I want to write in terms like the Y equals to something X. So the question here is it X power 1, X power 2, X power 3? Okay. Again, if I compare like that, the I is my Y. The T is my X. Look at the power of T. Is it 1, 2, or 3?
1.
Power 1, right? There's no number on top. So this power is actually 1. Which means it's as if I have Y equals to not X cubed, but X power 1 as well. And this number here, is it fixed or changing? Let's try to understand. P is the principal. Is it fixed or changing?
Fixed.
It's the starting amount of money I have. R is the interest rate. Is it every year changing?
No.
No, that means fixed number. What is this number? Fixed, constant, or changing number?
Fixed, constant.
This is a constant. If this is constant, that means this is the constant, like a number like that. So example, y equals to 2x. How does this line look like? Is it a curve or a straight line?
Straight
line. Which means scenario 1 must be either A,
B,
E. Now, what is the answer?
But cannot be E.
Just now, Jared said, how can it be E? How can it be A? A means what? I start with 0, right?
Yeah.
Time is 0. But does it make sense time is 0, I is 0? Does it make sense? Again, I repeat. Does it make sense when I first started, my interest is zero? Does it make sense?
Right.
It makes sense, what?
I haven't gone for
1 year. Yeah, I haven't 1 year yet, what? Because after 1 year, then I earn interest, right? Now, E says what? E says, at the start, without any time, any money, without any time, the bank already pay you interest. Is it possible?
No.
No, what? So this is wrong, what? This one is what? This one means, at the start,
okay,
I give you money, but after I lose money and lose money and lose money and lose money. Is it that possible?
No.
No. So the answer is A. Can follow? Can Now let's do scenario two. Scenario two
is okay.
Okay, let's do scenario two. First scenario two. Can you draw an axis? Label the axis for me. You say I write down. What is the Y?
The amount.
This amount, is it principal, interest,
total,
or total?
Total.
What is my horizontal?
Time.
Is there a formula to help me?
Yes. A is equals to P.
Ding-ting. Do you know why I pause?
No.
No one can answer me.
No.
This is A. Yeah. Is it found there?
Yeah.
This is time. Yeah. Is it found there?
Yeah.
Where?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You know ah?
No.
Okay. I was thinking how to tell you eh. Okay, you know. It's linked ah, So this looks like a what kind of graph? Y equals to, help me. Now you see ah. Okay, now I teach you how to fish. Then you go and catch the fish. Now.
I catch a goldfish.
No. You need to understand these two ah. Now how to relate, how to create, you see ah. This thing is the Y, right? T is the X. Is X the base or the power?
Base.
That's why I write X as the base. This time is power 1. That means this is power 1. Can follow?
Yes.
Okay, now look at this. Look at this. This A is the Y. So I write like that. Not the power, but the base. This N is my?
Power.
Is the at the?
Base.
Base or power?
Power.
That means it's something like that. Do you follow?
Yeah.
Can you recognize?
Yeah.
So how does this graph look like?
The
aeroplane fly
so high
up. Do you remember? Is this one? Do you remember?
Yeah.
Okay. Guilty right? Because never remember right. So what's the answer? There's only two answers. D or F. So answer is F. Now last one. You want to try now?
C.
Do I need to go through? Scenario 3. Do I need to go through? Why not you try first and we compare?
Sure, I don't get it. Like, why is it C? Is it because of the fixed percentage, that's why? Like, in real life situation, right, a car can, like, every year, the car price will drop by a bit, what? Cannot, like, drop straight away. Is it due to the fixed percentage, that's why?
Okay, I answer question by question. The easier question to answer is depreciate. Now, depreciate means drop.
Drop.
So depreciate means drop. Now, what do I mean by a fixed percentage? Now, let's give example, shall we? So, let's say this percentage is 10%. 10%. So, what does it mean? I bought a car. The car costs $1,000. 1 year later, how much will it cost? Drop by 10%. How much does it cost? How much can I sell? How much can I sell? After 1 year. Okay, 10% of 1,000 is how much? 100 or 10? Or 1?
100.
That means after 1 year, it will drop to?
100.
Drop to 100 or drop to 900?
900.
Buy. I'm going to minus the percent, so it's 900. Understand? So second year, if I sell, it will be
800.
Which means if I were to plot this graph, this is the value, this is the time. Tell me, am I expecting a sloping up or sloping down?
Down
lah. Which graph?
C
or B. So which one?
Why is it C?
Why not?
Because
you
cannot go until
below
already,
right?
How can you sell
until
like 0?
What?
It's not
zero. It's not zero.
Yeah, no, it's
fixed percentage, right?
Because they say they want the car, then they want the time.
Drastically.
Okay. Can I talk? Can I start? Okay. Now, this is wrong. Where's my red color? This is wrong. Anyone can tell me why? The first one is correct. The second one is wrong.
Oh, I think
the keyword here is fixed percentage, not fixed amount. What you're doing is fixed amount, drop by 100. Next year, drop by 100. Next year, drop by 100.
No, no, no. Use the
10%, 900
times. Nah, 900 times 10%, which is $90. So it's not 800, it should be
810.
So the next one will be what? The next one will be what? Minus
again.
So do you see that? For B, right? It's every year drop $100. Every year drop $100. Then the constant. It's constant gradient. But this one means it will drop, but then it will not drop that much. Do you follow?
Okay. I thought the below part is the time, man.
Yeah. Below part is the time. Lost already. Don't know what I'm talking. Okay, I show you the two graph what it means. The first graph, okay, this graph means 1000, the next one is 900, the next one is 810. For this kind of graph, it will be something like that. 1000, 900, 800, 700. This is dropped by fixed amount. This is dropped by fixed percentage. Do you see the difference?
Yeah.
Because dropped by fixed amount, then you can see a straight line. Every year dropped by 100, every year dropped by 100. It's the same, the gradient is the same. But this one is a curve, so it's like that.
Because the weird thing is, the car dropped so much, the price.
We don't care about that.
It will. In actual life, it's also the same thing. Okay, in natural life, it's the same thing. Now, but if I present it this way, right, it's different from how we calculate, how I teach you for scenario 1 and 2, right? You want to learn the equation way?
Yeah.
Since you are taking O level.
Will you confuse us?
No,
equation
no.
Okay, the one. Okay, then never mind.